So you got the cops knocking on your door. Your kid has posted some risque photo on social media. Well, that's your fault. The kid shouldn't be on social media. Hey guys, welcome to The Example. My name's Devin. And today I want to talk to you guys about social media and your kids. I'm here on The Example to try to help Christians, through my experience, help them, you know, with, be better examples in their family, in the community, and where they work. So, social media. Me being in IT for about eight, nine years, I just wanted to share the importance of, in my opinion, getting your kids off social media. And give you three reasons why. And then, you know, a solution and to why it's important to get them off, why it's important not to have them on social media. First reason, all the social media platforms, they are, when, let's say, they say a racist term or any derogatory term or something inappropriate, that's in the atmosphere and on the internet forever. You know, so when they get going to college recruitment, you know, those recruiters are looking for those things. When they're looking at jobs, they're looking for those things. Two, images. If a kid shares some risque images, it's going to be put out on the internet. It's not getting off. There's nothing you can do about it. It's on there forever. Three, there's kids create beef and drama, you know, where before it was handled in school and after school, that was it. Now that beef and drama is continued on from the school settings on to social media. And so that creates another other issues. What's the benefits of getting them off social media? One is building their social skills, being able to talk one-on-one with people. Everybody's on their phone now, texting, emojis, all that. You want to build your kids' social skills where they're speaking to people one-on-one, they're solving their problems one-on-one, and they're not being trolls behind their phone, on the internet, you know, posting whatever. They need to build their social skills. Also, the benefits is just protecting your kids from having things on the internet that can affect them long-term. They just don't need to be on social media from 12, 10 all the way up to, I'd say 18. After 18, let them do what they want to do. But for right now, you as parents need to, you know, get them off those platforms, you know, have them build their social skills, minimize their risk of being exposed to things that can hurt them long-term for the rest of their lives. Right now, social media is really just for businesses and marketing, ads, things like that. It used to be for, you know, sharing family, staying in touch with family. It's just not that anymore. So I don't recommend it for our young kids, teens, mainly because they're just not mature enough to handle the large responsibilities that come with these social media platforms. So that's just a quick video I wanted to share, my first vlog. Hopefully it was clear and concise, and hopefully it helped some people out there on YouTube that's looking to for some parental advice. Again, I've had over 8 years IT experience, and that's just what I'm seeing. I know how these platforms work, and they're just not good for kids. So again, let's, Christians out there, let's continue to be the Christian example in our workplace, in our families and communities, and I hope this helped you out. Stay tuned for more. You guys take care.